once all your tiles and objects are placed in the room, you can move on to the Render tab. And this is where you can create one or more photorealistic views of your design. Tilelook allows you to render normal photographs, like these ones you see here. This is a published project on Tilelook. Or you can also create 360 renders, like this one, that you can share on your browser and even view with any VR, so virtual reality headset like Google Cardboard or Samsung Gear and so on. Okay, first of all, let's see how to render our project as it is without making any changes to the settings. The nice thing about Tilelook is that all the objects that we've placed and we've used in our project are already set with the correct materials and parameters for the render. So if we don't need to change these default materials, all we need to do is position the 3D view where we prefer to create the scene that we want to capture, and then click on the render button. From here we can then set some options, especially we can set the sun intensity to determine the amount of light that comes in from any window in our project. For example, if we start a render and then we see that the light from the outside is too bright, we can decrease this value. So we will close the render, decrease the value, and then start a new render with a new sun intensity value. And then we can also set the quality and denoise level, which we will see and explain later on. So for now, I'm just going to click on apply to start this render. You can see this is the rendering window. A render can take some minutes, and this depends on the CPU power of the computer, but also on the complexity of our project, so the amount of objects and tiles that we've been using, and of course also the image resolution that we choose. By default, the resolution of any render is in full HD, but we can change it, and we'll see briefly how to do that. On average, a render can take 10, 15, 20 minutes to fully complete, though we can also choose to stop our render at any point during the process, so we can save the result up to the stage that it got to. So for example, if I wait here until it gets to maybe 20%, I will be able to click on this button here, stop render. Okay, let's see when this happens. Okay, so we're at 19%, 20%. Now from this moment on, I can click on stop. Okay, and the program will then complete a short operation, which is called removing noise or denoising. Once this process is finished, I can already save the image. Okay, so the denoising is finished, so then I can click on save image, and then I simply need to choose where I want to save it, give it a name if I want to save in JPEG or PNG format. Another very important thing is that while I'm rendering a project like this, I can also minimize this window by clicking here and continue to work on my project. So for example, I could go back on the layout tiles tab to do some changes to the tiles. I could go onto the prices and quantities. I can go back to place objects to edit or add new objects in the design and so on. And this is while the rendering is still working. By clicking on any object in the 3D view while we are on the render tab, Tilelook will highlight the material that is applied to that object. For example, now that I've selected this object, I can see here the corresponding material. If I now double click on this material, I can open the material settings, this window here, material settings, and here we have various tabs. First of all, we can choose a type of material. These are types, for example, like chrome metal or satin metal. We have ceramic, we have glass. And you can see that while I'm changing this type, I can see the corresponding result in the 3D view. And we have, of course, also a default material, which is like saying a blank material. When we move on to the other tabs, we have the tab name color. Here we can choose to define a color for this material by just simply picking colors from here. Or instead, we can choose a texture. So for example, this was the texture applied to this material. If I click on the plus symbol here, I could go on the tag browser to look for a different kind of texture, for example, wood, maybe search for a particular type of wood. Okay, download. And you see now that the material has this new texture applied to it. Not only we can choose different colors and textures, but we can move on to the texture mapping. And from here, we can increase or decrease the texture scale by simply changing this value here. And we can see on the 3D view the corresponding result. Or we can move the texture on the X axis or the Y axis. Or even rotate if we prefer in a different way. Using materials, we can also manage light settings for any of our light emitting objects. For example, if I go to select this object here and find the corresponding material, I can double click on the material, and this time I'm going to move to the emission tab. This is where I can first of all select this checkbox to enable or disable the emission for this material. So basically like switching a light on or off for the material. And then here below we can set the power in watts and the efficacy in lumens. So these are common emission units that are indicated on the boxes of any light bulb that we purchase. So we can change the settings of our lamps and lights in the room and then view the results when we launch the render. Okay, but how do we make more renders for our project from different points of view? And also, how do we create 360 views of the room like we saw here on the website? Okay, so by default, the project on Tilelook has one camera, and you can see this. This is the camera preview here on the top right. This records the current viewpoint inside of the 3D view. So if you change position in the 3D view, you can also see that the preview of this camera up here also changes. By clicking on Add Camera, I can create a new viewpoint. At the beginning, it will be in the same place, but I simply need to move the camera, so the position of the 3D view, somewhere else. So now, for example, if I click on the previous camera here, I can switch back to the previous position. And if I click on the second camera, I can go to this other position in the 3D view. If I now click on render, I will be able to choose if I want to render both cameras. You see here camera 9 and camera 10, or just camera 10, or maybe just camera 9, and so on. So I can even launch multiple renders in one go. By double clicking on a camera preview here on the top right, I can view the image in full size. I can do this either if the camera has been rendered, or even if it's not been rendered yet. I could also save just like a screenshot of the 3D view to a file, to a JPEG file. Also, we have a small tool here on the top, which switches from a colored view, like this one we have here, to a black and white view. So for example, I could decide to save a camera in black and white like this by opening the camera image and then clicking on save. Before rendering, we can change the camera settings to choose the format that we prefer for our final render. So we just need to pick a camera, so in this case the first one, and then click on this icon here, the pencil icon here below, to edit the camera settings. So from this window we can first of all select a camera type. So by default this is set to perspective, which means a normal photograph. Otherwise we can set a panorama or a stereographic panorama. Both of these camera types are needed to create a 360 render to view in VR. If you are interested in how this works exactly, you can check our tutorial about 360 renders that I will link at the end of this video. Moving on, in the camera settings, we can then choose a camera format. So for example, we can choose a square, 1x1, or we can choose 4x3, 16x9, and so on. These are all different proportions, and you can view a small rectangle just beside the proportion here to give you a better idea. So usually by default it's set to this value here. And then below we can decide the image resolution. So we can choose small or medium, which is very good to share on the web, for example, or we can choose a full HD resolution, or even a large 4K display, or large for printing on A4 paper or A3 paper. If we prefer, we can set a custom resolution. And so in this case, if we also set a custom format, we can simply write the number of pixels that we prefer for the width and the height of the image. I just want to show you, so I'm going to put back this value here, and also a full HD display, and click on apply, and you can see that the 3D view has been slightly adapted to this new format, so that while I'm moving the 3D view around, I can be sure of what exactly will be included in my picture frame. Okay, so when we finish setting up our cameras, we then simply need to click on render, and then we can choose which cameras we want to render. So if we pick more cameras together, Tilelook will render each one, one by one, until it finishes. Here, I didn't mention this before, but we also have a rendering quality, and this is a different parameter than the resolution. So I suggest to use the default value, or maybe a lower value if you need to do a quick test of the render just to see the lighting and materials. If you use a higher value, this will not improve the resolution, because that's a camera setting that we just saw, and it will increase the rendering time very much. Okay, then once you render all of your cameras and you save the project, all the cameras will be present in the online page of your project, so it will be posted on Tilelook once you save it and publish it. Also, when we will see how to export the project onto a PDF document, all the cameras will be available to be printed in a PDF that you can then export and show to your customers.